Now, as we're entering the factory on a normal production day, there's just a couple of rules and guidelines I'd like you to adhere to for your own comfort and safety. We were founded in 1783 by the brothers George and William Penrose. Back then, the factory was situated in the centre of the city, the place locally known as Ann Street, where we employed a mere 50 workers. Now, in 1966, we became a publicly owned company, and in 1971, we were forced to relocate to this 40-acre site in Kilbarry, where we now employ in excess of 900 workers.
With some 350,000 visitors annually, and ranking as Ireland's fourth largest tourist attraction, the visitor centre is one of Waterford Crystal's undoubted success stories. But as the mostly American visitors take the short bus trip to the tourist trail, they could be forgiven for thinking that Waterford Crystal was still a predominantly craft-based industry.
The crafts you will see today as we make our way through the factory are blowing, cutting and engraving. Each of these crafts take a 5-year apprenticeship to qualify, with a further 3 years to master the craft. So that's 8 years in total for blowing and cutting, and a 10-year apprenticeship for engraving. The extra 2 years are spent in the local art college. As you'll see, it's a very art-orientated craft.
The illusion is perpetuated as the tourists marvel at the magnificent skills of the blowers, cutters and engravers they encounter along the trail.
Now, the three ingredients we use in our molten crystal are silica sand, potash and litharge. Litharge is the 33% lead oxide ingredient, which gives the crystal its characteristic weight and sparkle and distinguishes it from normal glass. Now, these ingredients are hoisted at the tank furnace. They then burn and melt and fuse together at a temperature of 1300 degrees centigrade. The tank furnace is powered by electricity and it produces about 20 tonnes of molten crystal every day.
And purchasing a Waterford Crystal product in the retail gallery at the end of the trail, they would have good reason to assume the glass they would soon bring home was made by hand and in the factory they had just visited. In fact, the tourist trail is at once a memorial to the craft of glassmaking and an eloquent testimony to the virtual revolution which has taken place in Waterford Crystal over the course of the last 20 years. The cutters and blowers referred to by the tour guide now number less than 150. The last apprentice was taken on more than a decade ago, the surviving craftsmen for the most part working the tourist trail, just a few metres away from the tank furnace and automated cutting machines, which unseen by the tourist have decimated their craft in order to protect their jobs.